edge and smashing the tip of your board through the glistening wave while watching the foamy water scatter past your eyes. With a southwest breeze catching the rim of your hair. You catch the perfect wave balancing on a slippery board, but something goes wrong. You tumble off your board, rolling through the water like you're in a washing machine. You're excited to try again. This time you catch the wave, you slowly stand up on your board, and the force of the wave carries you to the shore. Would you love to do this? You just need to be fit, a confident swimmer, access to a surfboard, a beach with waves, and maybe a wetsuit if it's cold. Is surfing good for you? My most favourite thing about surfing is that it's good for the mind and soul. Plus, it keeps you fitter. What if you can't surf? If you can't surf, you could go down to the nearest surf beach and ask for lessons. What other sports does surfing relate to? Those that can skate are normally good surfboarders. Surfing has the same balance and movement as skateboarding. Surfing is a year-round sport that you can do in daylight hours. You can surf both in winter and summer, but you need a wetsuit to keep you warm in winter. It is fun for you, keeps you fit, and you meet other surfers to be friends with at the beach. Is it addictive? Well, in my point of view, it is completely addictive. I would do it every day. Where could you get a surfboard? You could get one from Rickley. Are surfboards expensive? Well, surfboards start around $600 to $700, but custom boards cost more. My challenge for you is to ask your mum and dad for a surfboard and go surfing. I bet you'll really enjoy being out in the steaming sun doing tricks if you can and trying to make some friends.